Mr. Crumpton,
hi,
good morning.
Hello. Good morning, you kids, Wade, Sissy, and Christy. I know you guys are happy because there's I bet there's some Halloween candy somewhere on that anchor disc that we can't see. Okay. Yeah. Well, Wayne, we know what you have in your desk drawer.
Whoppers, gummy bears, some chocolate
you
eyeballs.
Put in your
gummy
drawer? Bears,
you know what? I left those chocolate eyeballs yesterday.
You left them in your suit jacket?
No, I left them on the sink in there.
I think they're gone.
They're gone. And they were chocolate.
Yeah, chocolate eyeballs. Mm-hmm. You're really looking forward to that.
Well, Sissy was taking a few and putting it in her.
I put them in Wayne's pocket.
I know. And I'm wondering, how did they get here? And I just set them there.
You're such a giver.
She is such a giver, Sissy.
That is so amazing of you. Okay.
Yeah, she is.
Well, speaking of giving, one of the biggest gifts has been given to the Cleveland Museum of Art, one of the best museums in the entire country, 100 pieces, which is great. Biggest gift, Brittany, for the past 60 years. That's pretty awesome.
That is true. Yes, it's amazing. It's amazing to have a collection like this here in Cleveland.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Now, this one is catching my eye, and it's kind of popular. Well, Lamont's going to go close because, to me, it's this beautiful optical illusion. Once you get really, really close, you see how the artist just basically, in a sense, used dots to create this image. And then when you pull back, which Lamont's going to do, you really see it come into play, which makes it even more fascinating.
Okay? Yeah. Yes, I think this wall is especially great because there's one painting from the Keithley gift, one painting that was already in our collection. Mm-hmm. And so you can see how the gift really, you know, complemented what we already had and really brought the collection together. But these are both artists in 1890s France specifically, who are moving past Impressionism and starting to use, as you said, dots instead of brush strokes.
To get them in there, that's so cool. Now,
really
we come
cool.
around here, a lot of fun artists who decided, let's stick together. They just graduated from art school together.
Right, right. So this is one of my favorite parts of the Keithley collection. One of their favorite artists was this group of artists called the Nabi. Mm-hmm. And they met when they were in art school in the late 19th century. They were drawn together by the fact that they wanted to do something totally different from what they were learning.
Yeah.
And they especially liked to make prints, which is what we're seeing in this gallery.
They were rebels, art
they
rebels.
They were rebels, definitely.
Now, this is great because this is unique because these four panels presented like this is very, very rare, correct?
It's incredibly rare. So this is a four-paneled screen by an artist named Pierre Bonnard, and one of the founding members of the Nabi. And in this screen, I think it's crazy to think about the screen as something that was designed to decorate people's homes.
Yeah.
It's pretty wild to me to imagine this in your home today. But the Nabi were especially interested in depicting public and private life in Paris during their time.
Mm-hmm.
And so what they're showing here is a Parisian street that's right next to a park. And so along the back, we have a row of horse-drawn cabs.
Right, a parking lot,
yeah,
so to speak, back then.
Yeah, and then the next row is nursemaids or nannies who are just taking a break and relaxing. And then in the foreground, we have this very fashionably dressed mom and her kids playing with hoops. And then my favorite part of the screen, which is the many dogs that are interspersed throughout the image.
So here you see the Fifi
and those are very refined dogs with the family, and then this kind of like wild pack of dogs.
Then you see
the
dog pound up here.
Like, exactly.
Because the Browns won.
Very Cleveland.
Very Cleveland. The Browns won. You say you have to say dog pound. And these guys are hanging by the horses, not like Fifi and Pepe.
Right.
And it's so awesome. Well, this is tremendous. And since I know you know this amazing fact, Brittany, how long is the exhibit here?
The exhibit is open until January 8th, so you still have plenty of time to come and see it.
So awesome. Thank you so
Thank
much.
Thank you so much.
On behalf of Fifi and Pepe, we appreciate you coming out. Okay, we're going back to you guys in the studio.